Hey, Ed Lester here, and this is Showtime SPL. Welcome to the how-to video series of how-to videos for Showtime SPL. Let me show you something. Today we're going to look at how to remove some of the interior panels from your car or truck. You have kick panels and running boards and other types of interior panels that you want to take out to run wire, to deaden the steel, whatever it may be. Now, there's a couple different tools you can use for that. I have some here. And these are panel removal tools, panel pops you can call them, body panel tools, whatever you want to call them. There's many different types. I have plastic ones here. I had an expensive one that had rounded corners and whatnot. It was metal and it was $45. Kept leaving it in customers' cars, so you got to think about that. This whole set was like $15. So, like I said, a couple different types, and the plastic ones are great because you can get into tight gaps between the panels and not scratch up soft plastics, vinyl, leather, things like that. Now, it's important to know that different cars may have different styles of fasteners. Different eras of cars also do. So the two types of cars that I'm going to show you, I can't show you every type, but I have a Chevy HHR, it's a 2008, and a 2017 Hyundai Elantra. Now let's start with the Hyundai. Here's the sill panel. Now just inspect around to see how it's constructed, how it's fastened to the vehicle. I use both hands and I pull a little bit just to see where the pressure is. I start checking out the edges with my panel pop tool. I see there's no screws, of course. And I see that the weather stripping is over the panel. So to get the panel out, I have to first pull off the weather stripping. This isn't true in every car, but I found this out just by inspecting and looking around carefully before I just pulled on things. And here I can see in the gap where the clips are. There's enough room I could fit my panel pop tool and pull directly where the fastener clips are. The plastic is reinforced there so it won't bend as it would if you pull in other areas. So try and pull right here where the clip is because of the reinforcement. It's nice and strong and meant to be able to be pried upon there. Now let's look at the kick panel. Here's the hood release. Again, inspect it first before pulling it off. I see there's no screw, just a pressure clip, and I pull right where that clip is, and it pops off. Like that. And you can see that the stem is just a piece of plastic, and it's just held on by pressure. So again, pull the panel just a little bit, just wiggling it around with your hands to see where the pressure is. And you'll be able to feel that it's being held on in a certain area. Look there and find a clip. If you can get in the edge, in the gap between the metal and the plastic, you can pry it up. There's another clip here and I can't reach it. So I use both hands, wiggle it, and pull it out. And you can see that the clip was in the middle, out of reach of the panel pop tool. But pulling in the front and the back spread the force over the larger surface area and allowed me to pull it off. Now let's look at the HHR. This is my car, so this panel's been off 100 times. It is loose, but still, I'm looking at how the panels are put in place. I can see the sill is over the kick panel, needs to come out first. Using my hands first, I wiggle it, see where the pressure is, and this was easy enough to pull right off. Notice how I didn't pull up in the corner where it would bend the plastic, I pulled from underneath. Now, if I want to use my metal tool, I don't put it in between the two pieces of plastic because it would mar it up. Instead, I go to the edge and underneath right where the fastener is. Can feel the fastener so I can get the tool up under there and pull it right up. If I want to use the plastic tool, I can get in between the gap between both plastic panels. They're tapered and sharp enough where it can fit through and you can feel where the clip is, so if you get it right on there, it comes right up. And look at this. The notch in the tool is meant to fit right around these rectangular clips. And if you get in there right where the plastic reinforcement is, you can pry it right up. So now the kick panel. Again, the important thing is to look around, feel the pressure. I can feel a clip there. So I start pulling, tugging, not just pulling with brute force, but wiggling it a little bit until it pops out. Use a fine touch and just feel where the pressure is. All right, let's go back to the Hyundai, and here's an interior panel, a dash or a console panel. They're constructed a little bit different. Very important to inspect these. It's all plastic on plastic. Look for any seams and gaps. Sometimes these seams are cosmetic and the panel's actually one piece. Usually if there's two different finishes or the various shapes, you can see the gap, and these will be two panels put together. I can use my plastic tool and push it in the gap to see if there's any separation. If I see movement and I see a separation, then I could push it in and start prying up a little bit. And this one actually came out fairly easily. Once in there, I can see the clips. I can see them myself, so I use my hands. I like using my hands more than the tool. It's just a finer touch. I can get leverage in certain areas where the tool can't alone. And once I get it up enough, I have to move the shifter on this one. Set the parking brake if you do this. Don't let your car, and don't start the car. It's gonna roll away on you. So if it's up enough, you can fit both hands in there, start prying up, spreading that force along the entire panel so that you can pull it up gently and not break a clip off. Now once you have it up enough, you can look in there to see how the rest of the panel's constructed. You can see screws or pops or whatever you need to see to get the rest of it apart. Let's go back to the HHR, and again an interior panel, and I feel around just to see how it's put on, see where the clips may be, see what kind of pressure I need to get it off. And I want to use my plastic tool to get in between this panel, and if I slide it up and around in this seam, it stops where the actual clip is, and that's where I want to pry, that's where I put the force. That way it doesn't bend the panel and mess up the plastic. You can see where all the clips were in this one. That can be a lot of work, but it's fun work, right? Well, I have fun doing these videos, and I appreciate you guys stopping by to check them out. Check out the other videos in this series. You know, the reason I do this is to try and pass what little knowledge I have along to you guys, and hopefully it has some value. Well, if you find it useful, then it does have value. And let's all pass our knowledge around. That makes things better, right? And let's have fun working on our cars, because this stuff is great. See you guys next time.